May you speak to us, knowing that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from your mouth. And the just shall live by faith, and faith cometh by hearing and hearing your word. May doubt be dissolved, and faith be conceived, as we hear your word to receive from you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. The Lord bless you. Thank you, every one of us who have joined us. Thank you, Pastor, for being with us. And also, those of us who have joined us via Facebook, God bless you. We are continuing with our theme scripture in the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 20. Where the Bible says, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask, think, or even imagine, according to the power that worketh with us. Today, I want to speak concerning the power of association. And we will read also a scripture in the book of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20. And this is what the Bible says: he that walketh with a wise man shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. The power of association. Power of association. And we have been saying that God is able. God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all, according to the power that worketh in us. It is the power that worketh in us that triggers the ability of God to intervene in our lives, and for God to do only what he himself can do as Yahweh. And today we want to look on the power of association, because that scripture in Proverbs 13, that scripture in Proverbs 13 has a great deal of one's life. And it says that he that walketh with wise men shall be wise. He might not be wise, but because of his association, because of the company of the people that he keeps, because of who he acquaints himself with, eventually, as time goes by, he will end up being like the company that he keeps. So the company that we keep is of great importance, very great importance. And that word companion, its definition is a friend, acquaintance, or partner, or someone with whom one spends time or keeps company with companion. The word companion, its definition is a friend, acquaintance, a partner, someone with whom one spends or keeps company with. And now the Bible tells us that if you are an acquaintance or a friend or a partner or someone who you spend time with or you keep company with, eventually, as time goes by, that one Well, the Englishman said that the birds of the same feather, they flock together. And another man said, show me your friends, and I will tell who you are and where you are heading to. Show me your friends. I will tell you who you are and your future. I will project it by the company that you keep, because eventually you will become like the company that you keep. So whoever walks with the wise. And one man sang and said that no man is an island. No man is an island. Eventually you have company. You have company. You have people. You have acquaintance. But you are not an island. Only an island stays alone. So every one of us has a company. He has acquaintance. He has friends. He has people who he keeps himself with. And now these people will determine who this person is. And so we are told that he that walketh with the wise, eventually he will become wise. But he that keepeth a company of fools, he will be destroyed. So that tells us that our company determines who we eventually end up with. And there are positive associations and there are negative associations. And now that word walk, that word, he that walketh with the wise shall be wise. That word walk, when I look at it in the dictionary, this one it was defined as a walk is a behavior or to pursue a course of life or to conduct oneself. And I love the number two definition. So we can say he that pursues a course of life with the wise. Hallelujah. He shall eventually be wise. And he that pursues a course of life with fools, he shall eventually be destroyed. So it is a pursuing of a course of life. And that word pursue means to follow. To follow, that is the word to pursue. To pursue is to follow. So we are pursuing a course of life. We are following a course of life. Or seeking to attain. Or to accomplish a goal. That is the one to pursue. To pursue is to follow. Seek to attain or accomplish a goal. So every one of us has a purpose here on earth, because we are not an accident. We are created with a purpose. And because we are peculiar and we are unique, it is true, our purpose is unique and is peculiar. But there are people who have pursued such a course of life that we are pursuing, although we are unique and peculiar. And that tells me that we are not the only one who have pursued that course of life. There are others who have gone before us. There are people who have gone before us in the course of life that we are pursuing, or in what we are seeking to attain, or the goal that we are desiring to accomplish in life. There are people who have gone before us in that area of our pursuit. And now we are being advised that by Proverbs 13, verse 20, that even in our pursuit, even as we follow and even as we want to attain or obtain a goal or accomplish it, then wisdom is
demands. Wisdom demands that we be observant. Wisdom demands that we be observant and that we might, as we seek to attain, look unto the company that we are keeping. Are they heading to where we are heading? Are they going to where we are desiring to attain? Are they in line with the accomplishment of our goal in life or purpose? If then they are not, they might not be doing a wrong thing, but they are not heading where we are heading. And now, because they are not heading where we are heading, if we keep their company, if we associate ourselves, eventually we will not attain our goal. Eventually we will not. Hallelujah. So the objective of association, the objective of keeping company, or the objective of following and pursuing those who have gone before us is mentorship. They have gone before us, they have marked their footsteps which we can follow, and also we can attain what we are pursuing as they have attained in their life. So the objective of association is mentorship. Eventually my desire is to be like, hallelujah, because we, our feelings, our thoughts, and our actions are the seed that we are sowing to the future harvest that we desire to see. And you don't sow backward, you sow forward, you sow going ahead, you don't sow backward. And so the Bible tells me in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 15, Ecclesiastes 10, verse 15, the labor of the foolish, wearing every one of them. Why? Because he knoweth not how to go to the city. The foolish has a desire, he has a purpose, he has a cause that he is pursuing. But because of lack of knowledge, how to go to the city. The foolish is not the only one who has ever desired or intended to go to the city. In that city, there are people who are there, who have gone before the foolish. But now, the foolish will wear himself. He will wear himself by his labor, trying to attain something which somebody else has already attained. And it would have been more better for him to join himself with that one who has already attained and follow in the footsteps. And eventually, at the end of the day, the fool will find himself in town, in the city. Because he that walketh with the wise, he might not be wise, but because he is walking with the wise, eventually he will end up being wise. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 10. The Bible says that if an axe be dull, one that does not sharpen. Hello? If an iron or an axe, if an iron be blunt, he that does not quick or sharpen the edge, then he must use more strength. He must use more strength. Why? Because we are normally told that experience is a good teacher. But he's not a good teacher, experience. Because he first gives you the examination. Then he teaches you the lesson after the exam and or the test. He gives you first the test and then the lesson comes later. But we know that the Bible says that strength, wisdom is profitable for direction. Wisdom is profitable for direction. Hallelujah. Hello. And so it is necessary for us as we pursue our course of life. Let us not learn by our own experience. We can use other people's experience in their lives and learn from them and apply the same wisdom that they apply. If an iron be blunt, if you lack knowledge, if you lack information of the way of what you are pursuing, then you will use more strength if you don't sharpen. Hallelujah. The Bible says, as iron sharpening iron. Hallelujah. As iron sharpening iron, so does a man sharpen his friend's countenance. Hello. So for us to avoid the use of more resources, more time, more strength, it would be better to join with the wise. Hallelujah. Because we have walked with the wise, hello, will eventually become wiser. And wisdom is profitable. Wisdom is profitable for success. Everybody, hallelujah, everybody is a 5-talent person in his area of his area of expertise. Everybody is an expert in his own area. You are an expert. You are a 5-talent person. Because the Bible speaks of Jesus when he gave the talents to the three men. One he gave him 5. The other one he gave 2. The other one he gave 1. And the Bible says, according to their ability, they were given. Hello? So, everybody in his own area of his expertise is a 5-talent person. Hallelujah. But in someone else's expertise, you are a 1-man gift or 1-man talent. You are a 1-man talent in my area. When I come to your field or to your office, you are the most. But when you come to my office, I am the most. In your area of expertise, you are 5 talent. In my area, I am 1 talent. In your area, you are 5. When I come to your area, I become a 1-talent person. When you come into my area, you become a 1-talent, although you are a 5-talent in your area. Hallelujah. And so, wisdom now instructs us that though I am a 1-talent in your area, it is necessary for me to associate myself with you so that in that area that I am a 1-talent person, I can create an environment through your expertise as an environment of 5 talents, because as I associate myself, hallelujah, even if I am a 1-talent in your area, eventually I will become a 5-talent. Hallelujah. And so, because every one of us, hallelujah, every one of us is a God somewhere. Every one of us is a God to somewhere. You are a God to somewhere. I am a God to somewhere. Hallelujah. And so you are associated with you, whether you are mighty or higher. Hallelujah. If you look in the book of Daniel, when the words were written on the wall, the king, I don't remember his name, hallelujah. Belshazzar, hallelujah. King Belshazzar could not read the writings on the wall. He called for astrologers and magicians, and they could not read the writing, hallelujah. But the queen, the higher and the mighty, you might be higher and mighty, but you you are headed to somewhere. The queen instructed the king, do not worry. There is someone that is known. Hallelujah. The queen became a door. Hallelujah. To the interpretation of the writings that were on the wall, which the king could not read. The queen, the high and the mighty. Hallelujah. In 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 2, the Bible speaks of Naaman. He was a mighty man of war, and he was leprous. Hallelujah. And although he was leprous, in verse 2, the Bible says that there was a house held in his house. And that house held, although he was lonely and despised, yet he was a door to somewhere. Because he is the one who connected the Naaman, hallelujah, to the prophet in Israel. And Naaman was healed of his leprosy. When he came to war, David was a mighty man of war, a five-talent man in the battlefield. But when time came of carrying the Ark of the Covenant, he was a zero.
Wow.
Or a one-talent. Hello? Because somebody died as he was trying to carry the Ark. Why? Because when the time came for Solomon to shift the Ark of the Covenant from the tabernacle to the temple, hallelujah, there was no death. The procession was smooth. Why? Because Solomon had gathered information and knowledge from his father on how, because of his association, with the father, he had ease to carry the Ark from the temple, from the tabernacle to the temple. When the city of Ziklag was burned by the Egyptians, and the Bible says, when David inquired of the Lord, should I pursue these people? Will I overtake them? And God told him,
yes,
you will recover all that. On his way, on his journey to recovery, hallelujah, on his way to recovery, he didn't know. He would have weighed himself, seeking a way to the city. But there was an Egyptian who was sick. Hallelujah. He was sick. He was feeble. He was dying. He was hungry. He was thirsty. Yet he was a dog. Oh, he who walks with the wise, he will be eventually become wise. So this Egyptian became a door to David. Hallelujah. May the Lord become and lead us to men who are doors into our lives, into the next level. For as iron sharpeneth iron, so does a man sharpen his friend's countenance. The Lord sent us help of men to sharpen us in our area of one talent. In the name of Jesus, in that area that you are one talent, associate yourself with a man who is my talent, and eventually you will create an environment of, although you are one talent in that area, but your environment will be five talents environment, and it will produce for you.
Oh my God.
The Lord help us. Hallelujah. Now, when you look at Philippians chapter 4, verse 9, this was the advice of Paul to the church of the Philippians. Sorry. Those things, the object of association is mentorship, is to learn, to look at your footsteps that I may follow in them. These things which you have both learned, we associate ourselves so that we might learn. Learn things that we should do and things that we should not do. The association that we associate with that man of five talents, where we are one talent, the intention is to learn, to be mentored, not only to the things that we should do, also things that we should not do.
I thought you would say amen there.
Hallelujah. So Paul is telling the Philippians, the things that you have learned by observation. and ungodly learning, we are also impacted for receiving this impartation. And the things that you have heard, our ears are always open to hear and to read between the lines, so that because it is saying that normally the successful people who we are following after, who have pursued the course that we desire to pursue of life, and they have gone ahead of us, at times they don't realize what they have been said. So when they are asked questions, they might not answer directly, but you are there to learn, between the lines. Let me be the first.
Amen.
We learn between the lines and hear. Hallelujah. Philippians 4:9.
Wow.
And it also says, not only hearing, even the things that you have seen, the things that you have seen, hallelujah, your eyes have to be opened. Hallelujah. For you to see those things which you desire in the course of your life that you are pursuing as you associate yourself with the wise. Eventually become wise. The Bible says this do, hallelujah. You should not only have, not only receive, not only hear, not only see, but also put it into practice. Because it is by practicing you will become perfect in that area. Hallelujah. Practice makes perfect, and the promise is the God of peace shall be. The God of peace shall be with you. 3 minutes as I finish. In 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 16. So I encourage you, wherefore I beseech you, you be followers of me. This is Paul. Having left footsteps, he is urging the Corinthian church that as I have walked, I have left marks of my footsteps, which you can follow, and eventually you will end up where I am, or you will be more better than I am because of your uniqueness. Hallelujah. And so the Passion Translation says, follow the example that I leave before you. The Passion Translation. Follow the example. Let me finish with this verse that is in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12. We will continue from there. Hallelujah. Hebrews 6, 12. That you be not slothful, be doers. Hallelujah. But followers of them. They are there who have gone before us, who have achieved, who have attained, hallelujah, whatever the cause that we are pursuing in life. And now the Bible says, let us not be slothful, because slothfulness will deny us or steal from us attaining as we follow. We might follow, but follow slothful. But the Bible says, be not slothful, hallelujah, but followers of them, them who have attained, them that you desire whatever they have in their lives, them that have 5 talents in their area, in which you are 1 talent in your area, follow them, for whosoever walketh with the wise will eventually be wiser. Follow them who through faith, hallelujah, and patience, faith and patience. Because it is not an overnight thing. Faith and patience. Faith speaks of believing that whatever you aspire to attain in your life, you will accomplish it. But it will, you will require, you see, these are requirements. Faith and patience. Faith and patience. They inherited the promises. Because we are the sons of God. And being sons of God, there is an inheritance of the promises of God. And God being our Father, the owner of the heavens and the earth, and we being his heirs, then as his heirs, we should, hallelujah, we should experience every promise that he has promised in our lives. But there is a company of association of who we keep. and the influence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you all the glory. Thank you for he that walketh with the wise will be wise, O God. And he, and as iron sharpened iron, so that a man sharpen his friend's countenance. Our desire, Lord, is to attain. We pursue the course of life of our purpose, following those who have gone ahead of us, that we may attain your promises and inherit them in our lives. Father, we pray that doors will be opened into our lives, more doors that will connect us with men and women whom God you have ordained on our way to our destiny, who we will associate with, and they will sharpen our lives. And in whichever area that you are one talent, we will have the opportunity and advantage of creating a five talent atmosphere that we might achieve. We thank you and we bless you. For the Holy Spirit, who is our teacher, he will guide us into those doors. We thank you, for it is in Jesus' name we pray.